Hello everyone, today we will use the physics trigger events to implement a magic projectile that can pierce its enemies. We will also add some VFX when the enemy is hit. Before we start, I want to point out that I will be using the Unity 2022.2.1F1 version with the preview 15 of the DOTS package. Yes, DOTS is officially out of experimental stage. We are not yet at a full release, but the preview 15 already comes with some improvements and bug fixes around the physics and editor stability. The main change you will notice is that now all Unity packages uses the Transform V2 system. That means the old Transform components have been replaced by new ones. All the details are in the documentation linked below. But long story short, you should now only use the local transform component to read or write the position of an entity, and the world transform and parent transform should only be read from. I have updated the tutorial code using different methods to create the local transform component. Okay, now let's dive into the implementation of our piercing projectile. We will use a trigger event that will inform us when the projectile collider is overlapping with an enemy collider. For that, we need to have at least one of our colliders set to raise the trigger event. I defined it in the physics shape of my projectile. The projectile also has a component to define its speed, which visual effect should be used when it hits a target, and how many targets it can hit at most. The last component is just to define the maximum lifetime of the projectile in case it does not hit the maximum number of enemies. These are then baked into ECS component and used by system to move the projectile and destroy it at the end of its lifetime. You should be able to figure how this is done based on what we've learned so far in our other videos. If not, go check out the series after this video. What interests us today is how we handle the trigger events. Well, that is done using an iTriggerEvent job. I won't detail the way job works in this video, but just know that a job is a piece of code that can be executed in parallel to the main thread. A job is declared as a struct implementing an interface. Then, in a system, the job is scheduled. To schedule our trigger events job, we need to provide the physics simulation and the dependency. The dependency will allow the job system to know when the job is safe to execute. More details on that in future videos. The iTriggerEvents job don't iterate over entities or components, so we will need to provide it with some components lookup to interact with the entity. In the job itself, the first thing we need to do is to identify which entities raised the event. We can use the lookup to know if each entity involved in the event has one or the other type of component we are interested in. Then we can check if we are handling an event that interests us. From there, all we have to do is to check that we did not already handle the collision with the same enemy. Unlike the game object physics, the DOTS physics simulation is stateless. So the trigger event can't tell us if we just entered the trigger, if we are still in the trigger, or if we exited the trigger. So we have to keep track on the projectile which entity we already hit. Otherwise, we would end up with something like this. With that taken care of, we can now damage and kill our enemies, apply the visual effect and destroy the projectile if it hits the maximum number of enemies. For the visual effect, you will notice we just instantiate a new entity. That entity is a prefab game object with a particle system attached to it. I'm using one from a popular asset in the asset store. Link in the description if you want to grab it. As you can see, apart from the particle system, there is no other authoring component. You will be happy to learn that Unity handles the hybrid approach out of the box for some components, including the particle system, and it also works with the VFX graph. Using what we learned today and taking advantage of the asset store, you should be one step closer to your tower defense game prototype. That's it for today, thanks for watching, like and share, and if you have any remark or question, leave it in the comments below or come join us on Discord. See you next time!